Now, this beautiful panoramic Tuscan vista is from the winery and vineyard of Caparzo, which is in the Montalcino area. It's probably literally 4 kilometers from Montalcino, 2 miles. It's very close to Pienza, about 20 kilometers, which is about 12 miles. Siena is about 40 kilometers and 25 miles, and it's about 80 miles from Florence. Before we talk about the painting, just give you a little background about this beautiful place. It was started producing wine in the late 60s, and in the late 90s, 1998, the property and the vineyard was purchased by Elisabetta Nudi Angelina, and along with her daughter Alessandra and her son Ignacio, they converted it into the current beautiful and quite exquisite vineyard that it is today. They divided an old farmhouse up into 3 apartments. They have a rooftop pool. It's just a really nice place to stay and relax. And back in about 2014, a good friend of Susan and mine, Freddie Mattson, who's a wine importer for Vineyard Brands, set up a time for us to visit Elisabetta and her husband, Roberta, at this beautiful vineyard. And we were able to spend a couple of days there, and I brought my easel and I began doing several paintings. And this is the first one. And again, this is a vista of the entire area, which I wanted to start first. And it encompasses quite a bit, as you can see, starting way at the back with the beautiful soft hills of Montalcino. And then we have the separate farmhouses. Subsequent to my painting this, when Roberta and Elisabetta were visiting us in the States and they were on a wine tour, they saw this painting. They said, that's their house way up on the back on the left. Now, part of this painting is very, very colorful and the other part is somewhat realistic. It's the dominant field in the middle, that's fairly realistic, whereas the cypress trees behind it are pretty colorful. And, you know, I can see a tint of a color in a tree, and then I may just make the tree the entire color. And that's kind of the fun of it. Again, when you do this, you don't want to ruin the integrity of the landscape. So it has to be very well balanced. And I think I did this in particularly balancing off with the earth colored field way in the background and the earth color of the vineyard in the front, in the foreground, and plus the path going over the right. So there, you have this mix there. And then these very detailed grapes. These are the Sangiovese grapes, which produce the famous Brunello di Montalcino, which Caparzo and some of the other vineyards in the Montalcino area are famous for. And I have to tell you, painting grapes is very tedious because that's almost, to me, like in the old days, I did a lot of portraits. It's not quick work. You take your time and you have to work the shading in. But I enjoy doing it because this particular painting, from my standpoint, it reflects a lot of skills that an artist can use. And basically with the landscapes, the mixture of the colors, and then almost getting back to throwing a few portraits in the foreground of the grapes. Now, the title of this painting is Luve di Caparzo, and it's 36 by 48. And I'd like to go on to some of the next paintings in the series. Now, continuing on with the panoramic, beautiful vistas from Caparzo, this is from another area on the property. As I mentioned, it's 90 hectares, which is about 225 acres or thereabouts. The top painting here was, I did some sketches and one small little oil sketch actually when I was there, but this is predominantly a studio painting, and it's a little bit bolder than the previous one we talked about. And this one has that combination that I started to work on, balancing magenta and yellow. There's that strong magenta in the middle, and of course the majority, the whole middle of the painting is just shade of yellow. Now, the other thing about yellow, which I've mentioned before, is it's not just yellow. When you look closely, there's many, many different shades that could produce this image of yellow. And it becomes more predominant if you look at the bottom painting, which is essentially a very close-up of the middle part of the top painting. And if you look at the bottom painting, you'll see the greens, you'll see some of the magentas that mix in the middle, you'll see them on the edge. But then again, and there's some oranges, but all that work together does create that feeling of yellow. And then on the top painting, we go back to balance against the cypress trees, which are fairly realistic, and the blue olive tree in the foreground with that, again, the beautiful sienna-colored soil of Tuscany. But this, very special, I believe the top painting, it's a really almost spiritual vision of a landscape. You can see tiny little houses. Way up on the top, there's a couple little houses on the left and on the right. And in the middle here, at the bottom, if you see the field right before it breaks into the yellow, there's another small house. And I it's one of those feelings paintings that, although bold in color, it does work and it creates an image that, in my opinion, is very spectacular. The difference on the bottom pane, one significant thing I like to talk about, which is it's a close-up, as I said, of the field above, but there's no sky. And very seldom do I do a painting with no sky. And you have to be careful, but it does, you have that feeling of looking down, and I think it also works. Now, these paintings, basically, the top one, 36 by 48, it's Il Passaggio di Montalcino, just simple landscape, and the bottom one, same title, but number two. Now, this next painting from the Caparzo Vineyard is called I Sapori della Toscana, The Flavors of Tuscany. This was worked on primarily at my studio back in Florence after we spent 2 days at the beautiful vineyard. Again, it's another large painting. It's 36 by 48. And once I did that initial painting we talked about a couple minutes ago, I started to do close-ups of different areas of the vineyard. So now this one, obviously, we're focusing on the grapes in the foreground in the vineyard. And there's a lot of detail. Once again, it's portrait painting with a different twist. But the interesting thing of this painting is once we get back the leaves in the vineyard, we go into that nice gold field. And then I have these three trees in the background, and it's the different times of day. You know, I've mentioned many times before, you see different colors in a 24-hour period, but you don't see them at that one particular point. But that's the beauty of being a painter, because you can put it in as one point. So these different colors sort of reflect different times of day, whereas the one in the middle, the soft blue, would be early. The greenish one on the left is sort of midday, and then the reddish on the right would be in the evening. And I'm not sure the significance, it's subconscious, of just doing the three in the middle, because there were quite a few in the field. But I do have the other four, three and a half olive trees over on the right, the light blues, and then some small little magenta ones. Then the background, fairly realistic, the beautiful Tuscan soil, which is blends in with the green of the hill and then the soft purples of the Montalcino hills in the Tuscan area. But once again, the grapes and the detail of the fields and the soil, it's very realistic. And obviously the grapes are exaggerated, but once again, it does work with this particular composition. All right, now here we have even a closer look at the grapes from Caparzo. Then this painting was worked on at my studio in Florence. It's a 36 by 48, another pretty large canvas, and it was a lot of work. The detail with the grapes, it just gets, they get bigger and bigger, but the background with the soil and the earth and then the leaves of the vines was, in my opinion, this is quite a composition. In fact, my good friend Massimo Zecchi, who owns a supply store that I've been dealing with for 20 years in Florence, he oftentimes comes to the studio and we talk about the work, and he has some beautiful expressions. And this one, he said, this was Il Profundo Anima di Toscana. It's the deep soul of Tuscany. And I just think you just have to look at the painting and think of that expression, the deep soul of Tuscany. I don't think we need to talk about this one anymore. I think you get the feeling. So on to the next. So now here it is. I finally had to do it after talking about painting grapes in the big paintings and the close-up of the grapes, and it was almost like doing portraits, but I had them all grouped together. I finally had to break down and do one single grape group portrait. And here it is. The title of this painting, it's a small 16 by 20. It's called Freddy's Grapes. It's in the possession of Fred Matson from Armagh, Ireland and Sarasota, Florida. Okay, in the previous screens, we talked about the paintings that I created from a two-day visit to the beautiful Caparzo Vineyard and Winery in the Montalcino area. But as I mentioned, when we were only there for a couple of days, I did some sketching. I did have one small canvas where I began this painting that's standing in front of me on my deck here. But all of the work was done back at my studio here, which is on the roof of our apartment at Via di Oriolio, where we lived for 5 years, and I had this terrific studio. Also, I had a studio inside. In fact, to my left is a door that goes to the pigeonella, they call it. And that's a room that I could work on the paintings when the weather got bad, which oftentimes in the fall, the late fall in Florence, we do get a lot of rain. But as you see, this is an absolutely spectacular place to work. These are the four of the paintings we discussed in the previous screens. You can reach out and touch the Duomo. That's the cathedral in Florence. That's how close this rooftop was. In fact, we've been told that no other buildings for centuries can be higher than four stories. So we were actually at the top of the world here. Once again, it was just a spectacular place for me to finish the work. And from these four paintings, probably took 6 to 8 weeks to finish after just a two-day visit. Now, the bottom photo here, this is Pambianco Wine and Food magazine. Pambianco is a company in Milan, Italy, that's a very well-respected news organization. They have a website, Pambianco News. They also have three magazines dedicated to, one to design, one to beauty, and the one to wine and food. In fact, in 2018, I received quite an honor because Anna Guild, who's the co-owner along with her husband, David Pambianco, she researched, she told me more than 1,000 artists online, and she chose my work to put on the cover of their initial magazine. This was the first wine and food magazine that they put out. So it was quite an honor to be selected from all those people. And then, in fact, this is the painting, the first painting that I did from Caparzo. So I was very honored to have this done. And this is a very nice article in the magazine about me, and it's all in Italian. All right, let's go on to the big painting that wrapped up all the work that we did at Caparzo on the next screen. Allora, here it is. This is my magnus opus from the 2014 visit to Caparzo Vineyards. This painting is called L'Uva di Montalcino, The Grapes of Montalcino. It's a massive 5 by 6 foot painting. It's actually 60 by 68 inches, not quite 6 feet. And it is the culmination of all the paintings that we talked about in the previous screens. And I mentioned in the last screen that we have this beautiful roof studio that I worked on and finished up paintings which I had started at Caparzo. And the paintings, the smaller 30, they're not that small, but the 36 by 48 paintings which we finished were approximately 8 weeks of painting. And then this particular painting, which I actually did in my inside studio because the canvas was too big to move out onto the roof. And it was also pretty much the month of November, which isn't the best weather for outside. But I had the background from all the other paintings. And this is, as I mentioned, the magnus opus, because we incorporate in this painting the entire panorama and beautiful vista of Montalcino in the background with the details of the grapes, which I'd shown in several of the previous paintings. But this one has it all. And if you take a look at the actual colors, there we have the soft violets of the hills of Montalcino, and we come forward to the very realistic greens of some cypress and fir trees and olive trees and the little home up on the left. Then again, this beautiful color of magenta for the field. And every now and then I do something that's fairly unconscious, but I put this one olive tree in the top of the field there, as you can see it. And then I have a whole line of olive trees over to the right, but there's it must be something spiritual that is just the unconscious that I put one little tree out in the middle there. But from an artistic point of view, the normal color is that beautiful earth tone, which we have in the bottom of the painting with the grapes. And I also have it up in the upper right-hand corner, that soft sienna color. But what I see at dusk, when the evening comes around, I see the switch to this little soft magenta. And it may only be a slight switch, but I love that color, and then I make the entire field that color. And then you have to be careful because I'm balancing in a very strong yellow of the vineyard and the grapes. But once again, I think the integrity works. And then, of course, we go down to the grapes themselves. And as I said before, it's like portrait painting 101. It's a lot of detail, and it took a lot of time. And also, there's a really wonderful perspective. If we start with the grapes on the left and we walk all the way down that field to the right, and you feel that wonderful feeling of going off into the distance. Now, the painting, as I mentioned, it was probably 8 weeks of follow-up with the work outside, and this one was probably another 4 weeks from beginning to end. And as you see on the top painting where I'm working on it, the top photo, a lot of times, this is the easy part, I'm standing, but a lot of times I had to sit, particularly when I was doing the grapes, and then I had to actually go on my hands and knees to finish the soil beneath the grapes. But again, a labor of love, a combination of 8 or 9 other paintings, and again, from 2-day visit to the beautiful vineyard of Caparzo, I ended up with basically the entire month of September, October, November in 2014 doing the work. But it was a wonderful trip, and I want to thank our friend Freddie Mattson from Arrangia, and of course, Elisabetta and Roberto for being wonderful hosts. Thank you. Actually, before I leave, I would like to mention that in the winter of 2017, the Florida Wine Fest and Auction, which is a major fundraiser for children's charities on the west coast of Florida, headed by our good friend Sandy Lovner, selected this painting as the featured painting for that wine fest. Thank you.